Well, we've now come a long way, and we're ready for the final steps. What have we just learned? Well, we learned that our model is qualitatively able to capture the phenomena, but quantitatively, it's not the greatest. And in fact, our alternative hypothesis, which looks at first glance to do a better qualitative job, quantitatively only made things worse. We should have learned at this point that a noisy vestibular acceleration signal can give rise to illusory motion. However, disambiguating the optic flow by adding the vestibular signal simply added a lot of noise. This was not a plausible thing for the brain to do. Somehow, we've missed a key principle, or we're not doing things entirely correctly. The other thing that we thought might deal with this additive noise by doing credit assignment, it produced plots that seemed to have a better qualitative agreement, but our simulations were not able to match the frequency of the illusion on a trial-by-trial basis. So at this point, although it might be possible to refine our models and improve the fits, we've decided that you've learned enough. The whole goal of this exercise was not to generate a perfect explanation for this phenomena, just to remind you of that. It's to learn how to model. So let's go and write this up. To publish something, the first thing that you need to remember is, who's your audience? Who are you writing to? You should clearly describe what goals, hypotheses, and performance criteria you had during the modeling. You need to publish enough of the implementation details. And in fact, we encourage you to be entirely open science oriented so that your code, your equations, anything that you need to give people so that they can replicate what you've done should be made accessible via the OSF, GitHub, etc. What you're going to do now is try to write a summary of the project in a step-by-step fashion to ensure that you recognize the various steps that you went through and are able to generate appropriate language which expresses your understanding of what has happened. But in general, the structure is something that basically reflects a standard abstract in a non-standard form. So working through the steps, write down what is the phenomena, what is the key scientific question, what was your hypothesis, how did your model work, what did you find, did the model actually work, and what can you conclude from it, what did you learn, and what is left to be learned. Once you've written through these things and you've understood the steps that you've gone through, hopefully you can abstract these and apply these steps to your own research and to the other projects that you may engage in, both in NMA and in the rest of your career. I hope you've enjoyed the tutorial. As a final word, it's important to understand who you're talking to, who is your audience. And as a modeler, your audience is almost always experimentalists. Experimentalists are the ones who take a model and they do something good with it. They go and collect more data. They test a model's key ideas or assumptions. They interact with the model in key ways which further science. If you write for other modelers, you're kind of missing the whole scientific project. So experimentalists need to write and get data for modelers, and modelers need to model and write for experimentalists. If experimentalists and modelers are working together and are writing for each other, then science actually improves.